Yeah, it's secret, so...
Probably not going to happen. But looking at the options here, what do they have left for S4?
I mean, I think you could just pick a Viper and just win the lane so hard here. And S4 Viper is pretty strong.
Viper's not enough control, though. Especially versus those last two.
To me, when I look at this draft, I really feel like they need a miracle because I think they're completely outpicked, but that's how I see it. I think it's very scary. They need to win the lanes really hard because they have only single targets, and the others, they have so much control.
Yeah, they have like four single target, I think.
Yeah, and SF is not really... He doesn't control the teamfight, he just does damage.
Okay, thank you very much, gentlemen. We are almost ready for our first game in this second series of the day. Quarterfinal of the upper bracket. Let's find out whether Team Secret's favorite status is exactly what it is. We'll join our commentary team of Blitz and Philadelphia's very own Eagle, LD.
Thank you, Paul. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. We're live here in Key Arena, and I might not make it out of here alive at this rate, but of course, the Seahawks fans are being kept away for the moment. I'm LD. I am joined here by Blitz. Blitz is a 7K former Zephyr Storm player. What are your thoughts on the Storm pick this game?
Dang. I play other heroes. I just want to get that out there, but...
Come on. Do you really?
Yo, there's a lot. My mom's here. Come on. She's already under the impression that I only play that hero because she doesn't understand Dota.
I'm so sorry.
And so this isn't helping me out, but...
I've humiliated you.
All right, so Storm against this lineup is really good, but the thing is, if I think what Secret are looking to do, especially with that Viper pick, I think I called it early in our internal discussion, is I think what Secret want to do is just phase CTY out of the game. What Storm is incredibly weak against is if you decide to death ball, you gather up his five with the mech and just draw the line, say, we're never going to let you ball in, we'll always have backup. It's going to be incredibly hard to fight, but Ehome, they've got a lot of heroes to force good fights. ROTK, I really like that Phoenix pick. Before, it was one of the counters to Shadow Fiend. If you think about it, Shadow Fiend pops his BKB, uses his ultimate. All Phoenix has to do is charge the egg. You waste most of the charges on your BKB, and all of a sudden, you can't really fight the Phoenix.
It is definitely a different approach here from Secret, but I think one thing worth discussing, and you've certainly talked about it a bit before in some of your previous casts, a lot of players have also echoed this sentiment. Shadow Fiend is a lot more popular on the Radiant side.
Yeah, I think we talked in the lunchroom and you're like, it doesn't make a difference, but it does, because the fact that you can safely stack your own jungle, you don't really need a reliable support to, but having a reliable support helps. It's really hard to invade that side, especially because if you have the tier 1 tower up, people can just TP support in if there's a smoke gank. It's incredibly risky.
Speaking of ganks, here we go off the bat. ZYF wants to get in nice and early with the aggression. The charge comes through, but it's not going to get the kill just yet. They get it done! Secret, early first blood. The trade is Arteezy also falling. A crazy skirmish erupting in the river. But Ehome will end up backing off, so Secret, they get that first kill. Arteezy already given the TP and is going to head back towards mid immediately. Bounty runes, let's see who's gotten them. Arteezy did not get one. There's actually one going to RTK and one to CTY. So they get both bounty runes, but they are going to give up the first blood. Relatively even trade overall.
I don't think so, especially in the mid lane, giving up the bounty rune to the enemy mid hero, and he was the one that got the last hit on the kill. You're going to give such a big advantage to CTY early on. And this is an SF favored matchup, but with this sort of help, I don't actually think it is anymore. It's going to take a lot out of Arteezy to try to even this thing up.
Oh, we'll have to see if Zai wants to get into that middle lane at some point. For now, he is dual laning the top side. You've got Zai and Puppy. A pretty strong dual lane there up towards the top side of the map. S4 going to be soloing bottom versus RTK's Phoenix, who he did already skill up the Icarus dive, maybe expecting to... Or no, actually got the Fire Spirits, excuse me. So he is expecting the 1v1, and that's exactly what he's getting. But he's going to have a tough time staying this lane. You can see the harassment coming in, already being pushed back quite far.
And I really like Ehome's lineup. Like Matt said, there's a whole lot of control. You've got a lot of team fight to back up the fact that you have a bounty hunter. You can't just pick a bounty hunter and assume that he's going to help you win fights. He's the finisher and the opener. He's not really going to ever come in. You're just going to annoy people with the track. So you need almost pure team fight heroes to go along with him. And that's what the Winter Wyvern and the Phoenix provide for you.
Yeah, looking at the bounty hunter so far, he has gotten a deeper ward off towards the middle lane, trying to at least spot the movements of the secret supports, but we haven't actually seen him gone in. And there currently is a sentry ward sitting down here in the river. Lanham, not spotted right now, but it's going back to what the analyst said. Where do you go as the bounty hunter? Viper, a very tough gank in the early game, generally speaking. Oh, hold that thought. Zai getting pursued a bit top. He does have a charge available. He will back himself away. But this is not an easy kill lane either. Spearbreaker, Dazzle. So where do you think the bounty hunter should be applying the pressure?
I think you just roam around, see what opportunities you can get. There is an opportunity right now at bottom to kill S4. He's getting quite low. He does have the salve, but ROTK, what he's doing right now is getting him low enough so that he won't pop the salve, but he'll eat a tango. And
but look at this.
Oh, he has
they
a sentry.
Do have a sentry. Is he going to notice in time, though?
Well, go for it right
he tangos
now.
Through. He's going to commit to this one, and on they go to S4. He may be forced to turn and fight. He's going to retreat out. Fire Spirit's burning him down, though. It won't be the first blood, but it will be a big kill for Ehome. They get on the board. ROTK hits level 4. Lanham cracks level 2. And S4, playing a hero known for its lane dominance, not being allowed that 1v1 that he craves.
And you saw how well played ROTK did that. He got him in a range where S4 doesn't feel like he needs to use the salve because he has 5 tangos. And he has that sentry ward at the same time, so he feels like he's perfectly okay, but...
Oh, CTY's going for to the mid lane, but Arteezy turns.
Oh,
he's got
a
long range raise. He's going to connect. CTY getting a little over-eager there. And not able to hit that second remnant on the hero itself, only got the overload and was not enough for the kill.
That was just pure outplay there. Arteezy goes for the stick instead of going for the bottle first and is able to utilize that to get a kill. And Lanham, he's in this middle lane. He wants to grab that chicken.
It's going to be tough, though. Well, let's see. Gets the one attack off. He needs... Oh, the speed burst. Quick reactions. That was just a quarter of a second there to hit that and back off. Could have been a big kill on the courier there, but... SF able to hang on for now. And, well, taking a look at the CS, seems like Secret are pulling a bit ahead for the cores here. As far as the, in fact, for all three lanes, they are winning the farm battle early on, and as a result, they do pull ahead a bit in gold, about 500 so far.
A large portion of that just comes from the fact that Arteezy was able to solo kill CTY, something that should not happen at that phase of the game. You know that the SF wants to get aggressive on you, and Zai's going for the charge. They do have a ward here, but he should just back himself to the tower, and he should be fine.
CTY playing it safe now. It's about to be the 4-minute rune spawn anyway, so he'll work together with the Phoenix in the offlane and should be able to secure this. RTK getting aggressive now on Kuroki's Bane, who's only level 2, not really getting much experience. I do want to point out the Bounty Hunter dropped a sentry over near the big camp, looking to, I believe, block these pulls. Does this actually block it? Is that in range? The sentry over near the big camp.
I think it's close.
Okay.
I would have to see when...
Oh, are we going to see this again? Yep, there's the tango coming out. This time the courier has no speed burst ready. And Lanham, where once he doesn't succeed, he'll strike again, but the charge is coming in. Lanham almost dead and done. Doesn't deny to the Ancients. He was close, but couldn't get the job done. He did spend his gold here, picked up a pack of wards first.
I think it's well worth it. Dying for the courier at that point, you're only a level 3 bounty hunter. You're not adding too much value to the game. You have to get something, and going for courier snipes... It's a pretty decent way to do it, but the weird thing is when you play against a bounty hunter, you know he's going to do it every single time.
And it's just so hard to stop. I mean, you literally have to either ferry everything out or constantly just be camping the speed boost button with the hero. And Arteezy wanting to focus on mid there as well. I want to point out this bounty hunter has bought 4 more wards. And is this where you just go and block off every jungle camp as we see the dive on top lane? Zai getting pursued, but is graved up for now. We'll survive. Might be first back here. Now he's going to salve, hides in the trees. But yeah, what's the game plan here for our bounty hunter?
I think that is the point, and he's going to try to help out this bottom lane, but he doesn't have the egg quite yet. And S4 does have his ultimate, and I don't think they want to commit to this. There is a dust on Kuroki, so I don't think that the bounty hunter should be here. Maybe he's just looking to soak XP because he knows they don't have sentries, but
there's
they're definitely going to go on this.
He's got the dive available. Out comes another strike along with the brain set. The last auto attack, not quite enough. Will it take him down? ROTK barely surviving, and this gives Lanham free reign to walk into the jungle. A couple of pings came out. Did he actually shadow walk there? I don't think so, but they seem to expect him near this bottom rune. And I'm looking to grab it, getting eyes on Kuroki. A lot of pains. They want to control these, but CTY will get the bounty rune as Arteezy gets the real prize here, the double damage.
Yeah, and right now he's doing such a good job.
Oh, now they've actually seen him. Land, I'm playing with fire.
He still has 4 wards available, and I think this might be one of the counters to the Shadow Fiend where, you know, he won't show himself on the map, but if you just ward his entire jungle, you could just get rid of his...
There's a charge. It's a long way to go for Zai, but he is rushing in towards bottom, and thinks better of it. In fact, the real aggression's going to go the other way. With the dive in from RTK, he's hit level 6. He can deploy the egg here. Wants to hold it as long as possible, getting out the fire spirits, bringing him down. Haven't committed just yet. Will Secret be able to snipe him before he gets it off? In comes ZYF as well. The call down's an air ball. Kuroki just skirts away from it. The charge through 1-2 hits on Lanham. Can they focus him now? They've got a brain set. They get the kill. Now the egg, though, Secret fighting into it. But focusing with 3 heroes, kapow! It won't actually go off. Held it for a long time there. The backup arrives, it's up to CTY. Jump in number 1, gets Kuro. Will he go for more? He's pretty low on the mana. And in fact, pump fake on the charge as Zai We'll just back off towards the base. But Arteezy, he's getting a free time here in the mid lane now.
Yeah, and this is perfectly fine if you're Secret, because Puppy's going to soak XP atop. Arteezy's going to really hammer this mid tower. He's got full treads, an Aquila finished on the Courier. He has a DD rune right now, and I mean, he's just going to work.
It's just what happens with Shadow Fiend. If you don't constantly pressure him, the second you step back, he cleared out what I believe was a double stack, and he just keeps on farming the jungle from here. The camps haven't really been warded. They just placed one deep ward for Vision. But they're not slowing down Arteezy's economy whatsoever. And in fact, also topping the CS charts is S4, the two cores for Secret. Off to a hot start here in game number one.
Yeah, and this is the strength of the Shadow Fiend. Because he can clear the waves so quickly, it means that if you're a Storm player and you decide to leave the gank, which I think CTY had to, it means that there's a free creep wave at your tower every single time. If you notice, Arteezy, one raise, two raise, right-click the tower. That means CTY always has to rotate or somebody has to be there to respond, and it gives his team a lot of information. Because if nobody shows up, then he knows A, a gank's happening, or B, CTY's in his own jungle, and either way, it's just free space for him.
Well, speaking of free space, Puppy's found a lot here top. He's hit level 6 at 8 minutes in on a Dazzle. The dual lane helping out quite a bit. He's actually out-leveling Zai, who is the man enlisted to give some support to these other lanes. He's waiting for a charge opportunity now. No points in the Nether Strike just yet. And they have finally planted down a sentry near the big camp, but in some ways it feels the damage already done. There's the charge onto DDC. He was instantly ready with the Cold Embrace. That's not going to happen. Does force the Gyro TP out. He'll back off, and now bottom lane going to be freed up a bit for us as Lanham. Does a bit of leeching here off of Arteezy in the Radiant Woods, but there's the call down top. Zai trying to charge out. There's the Grave as well. Kept alive for now. Can they get him with the last Fire Spirit? No heal. Oh, he barely survives defensive sleep. Still, the Splinter Blast prevents the escape. Oh, they really tried. They pulled out everything in the medical kit there, but it wasn't enough to keep him alive.
You are seeing how difficult it is to kill Secret's heroes, though. You have to deal with the charge, the natural tankiness of almost all the heroes. I think Matt pointed it out yesterday where Bane's just one of those naturally tanky supports. You've got a shallow Grave that and nothing cuts through it. You've got a Spirit Breaker who, for some reason, was given 1,000 HP as a base and 7 armor to boot without any armor items. So you've just got a lineup that's incredibly hard to kill. Sooner or later, you're going to see a mech on S4, and Arteezy's doing... Actually, he's going to be the one grabbing the mech, and so... You've got a team that can pretty much just 5-man wherever they want, and this Storm Spirit hasn't had the best game. So for me, what's a little bit concerning is, what's CTY's place in this game?
Your guess is as good as mine right now. It feels like he's going to need a lot of time then. There aren't many stacks, but they are looking to just gank. Endlessly aggressive, but look who's waiting inside. He rotates in, 2-hero charge, follow-up stun. CTY barely escaping, now they drop the egg, but again, 3 heroes there to try and focus it down. They have to stop it. No, they can't. CTY denied. He jumps in to just prevent the egg from being killed off, and in doing so, he also hits the deck. Arteezy with the buckler, now going to push in this mid lane. He will kill it off. And Secret just starting to really pull ahead here in terms of the net worth. Now up to about a 4K gold lead, a 3K experience lead. And unlike CDEC, who you and I cast yesterday, there aren't big jungle stacks to fall back on here for EHOME. No ancient stacks for the gyrocopter, no big stacks in their own woods. And it's just going to make it hard to fight this battle of money with Secret, who are already so far ahead.
Yeah, what you're seeing right now was the power of the Shadow Fiend, is because he just clears out the waves. When CTY goes for the gank at the bottom lane, he can just push in the mid lane, and no other hero can stand up against him.
And there's the charge once again. Zai already galloping towards the top side of the map. DDC is level 7 here, but if nothing else, he gets some quick transportation towards the north. And he is scouted here by a Dire Observer Ward. He's still going for this. I don't think he commits any further. Well, Zai trying to test me, but he will back off. So they get control of the top tower. Doesn't actually have to go in. This will be tower number 2 for Secret, and taken freely. And now the mech comes online. The Viper of S4 has gone back for a Bracer, so he's just getting cheap tank items. Wouldn't be surprised even maybe a Drums comes out for him, and it looks like they want to push.
I think they had an internal discussion where S4 thought he was going to go for the mech, mm-hmm. hence the Ring of Regen, but I think they rethought that and said, Arteezy's doing such a good job, we can just get online really quickly. And I think this is in response to the fact that CTY is so underfarmed. If CTY had a point booster on top of what he already has with the treads, then maybe they can change their build or their playstyle a little bit, but because he doesn't, it's so incredibly hard for them to fight right now. Like CTY rolls in, all he'll do is run into a brick wall.
Not hard for Secret.
Not hard for Secret. There's the charge onto DDC. No cold embrace in time. He gets stunned. The cooldown's there. Pretty good one. Connects on two. Looking to focus Arteezy, but Puppy's ready in position with the grave. And out comes the Requiem. Dodged by the Phoenix Egg, but to what avail as they grip Z-Way up. They'll bring him down too. Arteezy juking for all he's worth. Did they even get him? Oh. The last remnant barely, just barely takes him down. But was it worth it? Four heroes collapse. The tower still falling. The gold swing not as bad as you would expect, but that's only because Secret are already so far ahead.
That wasn't significant for you? 1,400 gold going the other
four
way.
4-1, I thought, you know, 2,000's not out of the question here, but that was brutal.
Yeah, they lose a tier 2, and you saw the weakness of the Storm right there. He rolls in, he doesn't really have a target. Arteezy gets graved up, and then he's just kind of stuck in a situation where he has to flip a coin. Either A, I get out of here, or B, I just chance the kill on him, but most likely you're going to die there. I mean, he went for it, but that definitely wasn't worth it. And right now, Secret are just showing how to beat a Storm. You collectively group up as five with a mech, with naturally tanky heroes that can back each other up. And the counter initiation game from Secret is so strong right now. You don't even have a BKB on Arteezy yet. There's not even any real items on S4, and yet you're still struggling to get into fights. And that has to be so troublesome because heroes like Gyrocopter rely on winning the early game. All of your skill set naturally lends to it. And the fact that you're losing this hard in the early game does not bode well.
Secret on the smoke once again, and they move on towards mid. RTK doesn't have the egg available, but not clear if that's the hero they want. Well, yeah, you betcha it is. They're going to charge forward. They're committing for this quite heavily. Track is available now, and that will deter Zai. But that is something I think worth discussing more, is Phoenix not a very common pick right now, and we haven't seen an egg actually go off this game. I think we've seen three cast, and every single time, there's been two, three, even four Secret heroes that just instantly focus it down. And it feels like the impact of the Phoenix in the offlane just hasn't really been there for EHOME.
I think the idea was that you could use it in conjunction with the Winner's Curse just to create chaos on the map, but if you notice, every single time Secret YOLO dives on the DDC, and it's so difficult for them to stop that, because they don't really have an ability like Brave where you can deter them from going on a support. Like, all he has really is himself, and I mean, he's been a little bit out of position. I think he has to be in better positioning so that he doesn't just get charged and blown up in the beginning of the fight. And
speaking of charges, there's one on towards top. CYF in danger now. If he doesn't drop the call down immediately, he may just go down off the bat. There's the call down. Is it enough to force them back? The grip could come through, and it will. And even through the rocket, perhaps Secret show no mercy in butchering that poor Gyrocopter. And they're also taking the tower bottom during this time. Objectives everywhere, just piling in for Secret. EHOME completely thwarted every turn, it feels. They didn't try to bring RTK in mid along with the Bounty Hunter, but can't find any kill opportunities. This Storm, he's 2-3-1. He's just been shut down.
I think what EHOME have to do is just kind of extend the game a little bit longer, because CTY doesn't have any natural counters here. The only issue right now is that he's just running into a brick wall every single time he goes for a gank. Their heroes are just naturally tanky, it's hard to kill. So the better thing to do is extend the game for as long as possible. Like, this is not the normal CTY that we see. It seems like he's a little bit agitated, and he's going for really risky plays. All you have to do if you're CTY here is farm the jungle consistently, wait for your opportunities. If Secret go for the high ground, track up four different heroes, roll in with Storm, roll out, and eventually wait for Secret to overextend or make a mistake. But right now, I think if EHOME try to get aggressive, they'll lose every single time. Maybe you go for an individual smoke gank just to pick off one or two supports, but other than that, just play the high ground game.
Well, that does seem to be the way they want to go as a team strategically here. ZYF not going into the early BKB or drums that we've seen out of players like Aggressive. He's going for what looks to be a Helm of the Dominator, so he at least wants to farm. And for now, CTY has slowed the game down, is pushing in the middle lane and getting what creeps he can. But Secret playing defense. And I guess the question is, what is Secret waiting for? It looks like Arteezy just finished the BKB. And that may be cue to go into the pit. He's just picked up a haste rune as well. Level 13, everything pretty much maxed out here, aside from the ultimate and presence. He's ready for the big five-man fight, and all they have to cancel Requiem is really a Winter's Curse.
Yeah, and you don't really want to initiate it with that, because you want to be able to use it in tandem with the Supernova, but Secret are really denying them opportunities, and with this 10-second BKB, I think Secret just march down and take whatever objectives they want. I think they have to play face rush Dota right now. Go as fast as you can. Don't let EHOME gather up and take split pushes. Like, you just have to apply pressure at all points and kind of force EHOME into awkward situations.
And they do have to be careful, because this is a Bounty Hunter game, and as much as it feels like Secret has been in total control almost from the very start, maybe not when the runes spawn, but shortly thereafter, track gold can swing just about any game around right now, and the gold lead is
it's not that overwhelming. One bad fight and this is close to zero, so Secret wisely playing it safe, getting their core items up. They're going to get a little insurance here. S4 picking up the Midas, and they will smoke. They have thoroughly dewarded their side of the map. In fact, only really just that one Dire Observer ward remaining, and it's not in the right place to spot this, which is the move into the Roche Pit. They have a medallion available, and they go directly there. Ping coming out towards the top side of the map from Secret. They want, looks like Zai to show himself and maybe try to bait somebody onto this top tower. As the counter D ward comes from CTY, it's a freebie for Secret. Not even contested whatsoever. Ehome getting the lanes pushed out, but that's about it. And now Arteezy, well, this is a Shadow Fiend in his prime. 3k ahead of any hero in the game. We've seen this so many times as of late with Team Secret, and we see it again now. A nearly unkillable core hero that does the most damage on the map to boot.
It's going to be incredibly hard for Ehome to take any fights, so this is what they have to do. Apply pressure where they can. You notice that CTY goes mid, he forces some heroes to show themselves, and then they show themselves top.
I mean, just look at this. He's diving past tier 2s by himself. This man has no fear.
No, he doesn't. Did you understand that? That was a terrible
joke. He's so sad. Hey, they're both doing pretty well, so I guess they'll survive somehow. And now they jump out of the mid lane onto RTK. The mech comes out. They force it out nice and early. Arteezy still has the Aegis. He gets slept during the Winter's Curse, and there's nobody there to hit him. That's a big teamfight already down the drain. And Ehome may just have to sack this tower for free. The Hunter is becoming the Hunted rather quickly as the charge goes on to Lanham. I believe there is detection on Zai. No way out. Lanham is going to take this one in the mouth. Punched, then smacked by the Lantern. And he will go down to the Nether Strike. Secret taking a tower while collecting kills. It's been the story of this game.
And Ehome can't panic like that. The fact that they were willing to use the Winter's Curse on an SF that was diving their tier 3.
Like, with an Aegis and a BKB.
But he's not going to commit for that.
Yeah.
I felt like that was just an overreaction. And that means any single time they use any one of those spells, they can't get into fights anymore. And their Bounty Hunter simply just can't die. Like, they need the level 2 track up. And he's only level 8 right now. Like, the level 1 track might not even make enough of a difference where it really affects the gameplay. Because Secret can just continue to farm if they want. They don't have to use this Aegis. They'll most likely push out this wave and just go for tier 2s, but they actually opt to go for a smoke, and Ehome are going to have no idea right now that this is going on. They have no wards up. This is a pretty good timing for a smoke, just because they assume that Secret with that Aegis will go for the 5-man, but they opt to look for the pickoff first, and this is the safest way to just put a stamp on this game
now. They've got a grip available. Lanham will be the one to reveal it. Sentry Ward in the mid lane, now thrown out as Dust will come from Kuro. Not going to find anything, though. They'll back off, but they are congregating. 5 heroes on the mid. As Puppy moves up towards the north ramp, they're going to settle mid, and in they go. Arteezy in front, he just rushes in, says, come at me. You really can't stop this level of aggression. At least that's the plan. There's no Storm in sight. He's just split pushing, trying to stall the game, slow it down a little bit. They will spam Arteezy to some extent, but not enough to force him out of the base just yet. And meanwhile, while this is happening, also on the bottom lane, there's a bit of a push coming out here. Everything they can do just to discourage Secret from pushing in, but now the charge, ZYF, he's got about 5 seconds here to TP out before that charge will be in closing distance, and he will get out. So they do manage to escape. CTY, Bloodstone nearly complete now. It's on the late side of 20 minutes, but you said he needed to slow the game down, focus on farming, and that is what he's done. He hasn't died since we discussed that, and he is keeping within striking distance here of Secret.
This is exactly the game plan that I think Ehome should have shot for when the early ganks weren't working. Just go back to your farm. You know that you have the track. You've got enough to wave clear with the Splinter Blast, and any team is going to be deterred when you get 5-man track. You just can't afford to lose that fight because it would just give Ehome all the momentum in the world, and that's what Ehome have to play for right now, momentum. They've got a Bloodstone on their Storm Spirit. He gets around 14 charges. There's no natural counter to his hero on Team Secret. He can pretty much just do whatever he wants, and so it's actually a little bit on Secret to play perfectly from here on out, because you don't want to feed away track kills, and you especially don't want to feed away Bounty Hunter tracks.
And you mentioned momentum, and you could see with this deviation from Arteezy's build that Secret understand this is what the game is about right now, is trying to keep the lane shoved in. He's opted to go back for Boots of Travel, and we really don't see this or this early very often on a Shadow Fiend, but with this, he can split push better, still join the fights, and he can basically counter that play that we just saw out of Ehome only moments ago. Very interesting change up here, and I think it really speaks to what Matt said on the panel, that normally Secret prioritize a little more wave clear and spam from their supports, but, well, Arteezy is going to be the one-man pushing army at this rate.
And CTY, he's so afraid right now, but he has to just continue to push in as far as he can. They're pinging a top, but it looks like they want to ignore this. And
oh no, they're looking for the ancients. Secret. Just not even letting Ehome have a single penny, let alone two to rub together. They won't find anything here, and that may put them low on smokes for the foreseeable future. They just used two in quick succession, but it's Ehome's turn to pick one up. I mean, where does Ehome really go right now? Who's even the target at this point?
You don't really want to take a fight here. If you have to hit the Winner's Curse Phoenix Egg combo, there's no other way that you can really take a fight here.
It is a very game-changing combo, but like you said, not the easiest to hit. There's four ranged heroes on Secret.
It's just the tankiness of their lineup. They're actually just going to have to surprise Secret.
This could be the fight. They're coming up the ramp. They have the vision. Call down coming through as well. And it's a three-hero Winter's Curse. Locking them in place. No egg coming through. Yet he doesn't mana. No mana from ROTK. Oh, no. Can he hold on? He gets off the egg. And they're not actually focused. It's Secret. Arby pulls back. They're getting the advantage now. Crow could be next. Landham slept up, but they should get off the track here. Trying to die quickly. Track gold more and more piling in. Ehome found a pretty good fight, and now they hunt for Arteezy, who's dangerously low. Tracked up. Aldridge ball. CTY got him. What a pick. Now Landham backing off onto S4, who quickly tries to turn this one around. TP out. Not going to make it. Secret do salvage the fight. They make it a 3-for-2, but when there's track gold in play, and when you're that far ahead, well, you could see the results blitz. A 2,500 gold swing, a 2K experience jump. That was so big for Ehome.
And the other things that you don't really tangibly see in the stat sheet is 11 Bloodstone charges now on that Storm. It's going to be so much easier for him to force fights because he knows he doesn't have to rely on buyback. The natural Bloodstone timer will help him out so much in these fights. And CTY has to feel so confident because now he's halfway to his Orchid. You've got a level 9 Bounty Hunter. That's not ideal, but you've got a level 11 Phoenix, you've got the Winter Wyvern with the level 2 Winter's Curse, and you finally saw that combination pay off. Arteezy goes for the BKB ultimate, they Winter's Curse him, and then at the same time they drop the egg just 2 seconds later. ROTK, I mean, he was close.
ROTK doing the math, like pushing it to the absolute limit. He had like a couple inches left on the paper, and he found a way to scribble in the last numbers required. Barely getting that off, but we do see the potential of the draft. Not just the Winter's Curse into the egg, but the zoning potential of Gyrocopter as well. Discouraging Secret from going in, forcing out the early BKBs, and if they ever have to run, that's where the egg just ruins you as a lineup. And if Ehome can do that from behind, imagine how scary they'll be if they manage to catch up. So Secret slowing down again, going back to the farm game. The other consequence of that fight was they did manage to keep these wards up. Secret have not been de-warded. They've still got the hill ward we saw earlier, one also placed near the bottom rune. And so far up until this point, Secret have been very good at keeping the map dark, but now Ehome's starting to get a bit more vision and getting more active out on the map.
CTY is going to feel so confident about this bottom push because of the wards that they have set up. He knows that if anybody rotates in, he sees S4 right there. They have no vision. They have vision over there. They know that Secret have popped most of their smokes, if not all of them. He saw them use two in quick succession, so he's probably going to feel really confident just taking the enemy jungle for himself. This is one of my favorite places to see. You know that Secret want to get aggressive in five man. Just farm their own jungle because they will all be grouped up in yours. So this is how CTY is going to get ahead. And I mean, it's just better playstyle right now. And eventually he will get ahead. Like, he's only one level behind the Shadow Fiend, whereas he used to be 3 or 4.
There's no smokes for 4.5 minutes, and Rosh is coming up in 2.5. There's going to be a 2 minute window where Secret cannot smoke into the pit, and Ehome can if they want, or they can at least sit back and continue farming. That puts Secret at a pretty big strategic disadvantage for movements around the map. Maybe that's where Zai can find a good opportunity to charge, but no Shadow Blade. He's gone for that utility build, pick up the Vlad, and just trying to buff up Arteezy as much as possible in the fights.
And if you're Ehome, you want to take a fight in the Rosh pit.
They won't land him throughout the track. Most likely TPing out. Yeah, he's getting nervous now. And, well, they did get dewarded again, it looks like. They do have the gem on Puppy. That's going to make things trickier as the game moves along.
The one downside for Ehome's lineup is they don't have a medallion. They don't have natural damage dealers, so doing Rosh on themselves isn't really a possibility. It's not like you can five-man smoke in there and do it really quickly. It would take a good 30, 40 seconds for them to even get it to killing distance. But Secret, I mean, they don't have that issue. They've got a Viper that can naturally tank it. You've got a medallion on Puppy, and you've got a Shadow Fiend who has that presence of the Dark Lord, so it's a lot easier for them to do it. At the same time, I don't think Ehome want to keep it up for free. Like, that's their bread and butter, being able to fight in those tight and closed spaces.
It's so good for Phoenix as well. There's so many good places to put the egg where they're very likely, exactly. The Supernova, where they won't have vision.
But CTY just continues to farm out his own jungle now because he realizes that Ehome or Secret have actually all rotated down there. The downside is that Secret have to just bunch up together right now to protect each other.
His score may only be 4-3, but oh, they found Lanham. the life of a bounty hunter. It's like, hi guys, mercy please? No mercy. You have to take those risks. Get the wards out and also just be off the map so Secret play a little safe. But CTY, you pointed out he was dying a bit too much trying to hard to fight. It's now been like 15 minutes maybe, or at least 10 to 12, where he simply has not died. And he's still 4K behind Arteezy, but it feels like one good team fight with a couple track kills and it's more or less gone. DYF similarly, keeping his own farm up. And Secret just not pushing the tempo as much as it felt like they wanted to. They took the Aegis, they got the Boots of Travel, these felt like items ideally designed just to shove all the lanes out and then go for at least pressure on a tier 2 Arax. But now the jump on mid onto Arteezy, he's got the BKB, he will pop the Requiem now, and they're forced to turn tail and run. RTK may pay for this with his life, but the cooldown zones him, slows him down, and backs him off. Puppy there to ensure Arteezy doesn't fall, and they do have the tier 1, so actually killing him tough, but forcing out a BKB charge, still pretty nice here for Ehome. Down to 8 seconds. That's only the second BKB usage of the game.
Yeah, and this is, we've been talking about Ehome a lot, but I think Secret are playing this about as well as they can. They're keeping the lanes pushed in. They're picking off heroes that are showing themselves. They're not allowing Lanham to just get map control presence.
They've deboarded him, like, I don't know, 8 times this game.
I don't even think they're using... Oh, they actually bought their own gem now.
Yeah, they have their own gem. Ehome also picked their own up, but there was a long window there where neither team had a gem.
Yeah, they were just playing the guessing game. They were doing a good job about it, but... I mean, Secret are just playing patient, especially after that fight in the jungle. Secret realized they are vulnerable. Like, their lineup isn't unkillable by any stretch.
They're just walking in.
Oh, they have the medallion now on DDC.
They have the medallion, and they may just know that Secret don't have smokes based on how many they used earlier in the game, but
this ward spots them.
Uh-oh. Well, does it matter? Does Secret actually get here in time? They're starting to bring S4, and they have Vision on him, so they know that the rotation's coming. Wildkin Tornado looking to be the MVP. Used to be a big thing in these fights. S4 will be scouted by it, and so Secret really beginning to group up. The BKB of Arteezy is ready. Rush gets pretty dangerously low here. Not dead quite yet. And now the jump forward from CTY onto Puppy. Almost instantly bursts him down, but he does get half slipped up by Kuro. Save for now. Mechs up, stays alive. The charge forward. There's the curse. Oscillating S4 and bringing him down through BKB. Arteezy with his own BKB, but not doing that much damage during this time. Will they be able to hang on and turn this fight? There's no egg mana once again. ZYF getting put under. Arteezy again moving forward. The BKB of ZYF about to wear off. Track is there, but they've really used all resources without the Phoenix Egg. How can they hope to fight this? And now they sleep ZYF. They charge it again and club him with the lantern. Oh, the jagged glass will ultimately send him back to the well, but he's going to buy back on the gyrocopter, and they really are going to commit everything they've got for this Roshan. They already threw a lot in, and they want to do a little bit more. They know they have the egg available still around the pit. The BKBs from Secret are down. Ehome may end up taking the Roche for free here. Even with the buyback, still a gold win for them. And now they get the prized Aegis onto CTY, who did not die at that fight, and is up to 12 Bloodstone charges, suddenly level 17.
And this is a ticking time bomb right now for Secret, because every single time they kind of take an even fight, but they don't kill that Storm Shirt, they have to be so worried. So that Bloodstone counter is getting quite high. He's got 1,200 gold on top of that, and Lanham is finally getting near that level 2 track, but in Secret, the main problem there, I think, was that they showed themselves on the map. They knew that Kuro was pretty far away using this ward. They actually mass pinged him. They're like, go. Go on S4 right now. We don't have to do the Roshan. Just take the 4v5 fight, then we'll do the Rosh. We have the dire side advantage, and this is the real strength of being on the dire side and doing Roshan. You can buy it back and get there incredibly fast. I think the only person on Team Secret with Boots of Travel is Arteezy, and even then, you've only got that tier 2 bottom to TP2. You're not going to be there in time to contest it.
And we also saw the power of not having smokes as well as the track. They had a track on S4 off the bat, so they knew he was coming in. And they also, it seemed like, just knew that Secret wouldn't be able to smoke into the pit at all, so maybe they could have gotten a better jump, but it wasn't really the case. And then that was a fight without a Phoenix Ultimate. No Supernova there. Could have been very scary for Secret if he had mana. And it's getting to the point where RTK he's really crippled in this regard, but onto the middle lane, there's the jump on Puppy, the silence is there from the Argon, defensive sleep. Kuro was looking for it, but he couldn't quite get it off. Now the charge, they bait out the egg off the bat, but the Winter's Curse prevents them from killing it! And now Secret, before it's back, the egg's gonna go off! They're blasting him
with the Phoenix Ray and forcing S4 off of the fight. Arteezy has Requiemana though. BKB is starting to wear off. Can they turn this one around? He gets the first kill on RTK. He looks for more, but he's too low.
Oh,
and they're laid into him. Kept under, stays alive. DDC with the big bailout. And Ehome hunting Secret down. They've almost got S4 as well. He's going to die again. The lone survivor, Arteezy Shadow Fiend. The combo just so strong for Ehome.
I just want to point out that shuriken toss from Lan M, he throws it at one target, four others are tracked up, it bounces around, finally snipes Bane at the end of it, and what a dominant fight for Ehome. They don't even lose the Aegis there.
He actually did more damage than anyone except for his own gyrocopter. That's with a full duration Phoenix Egg going up, a storm in the fight. Oh, jeez.
He played that so well, and CTY all the way up to 13 Bloodstone charges. They're even going to take that tier 2 tower, even though it's denied. It's just the momentum shift. You can feel that Ehome, they know they're ahead now in this game. Even if everything doesn't reflect it, they know the momentum is in their favor. They've got the late game items. Eventually, Arteezy's going to have to replace that mech. You've got a BKB that's only 6 seconds now, and you don't really have the best way to deal with the Winner's Curse.
And now they're looking for the insurance policy as well, stacking up the Ancients. It's still relatively early here, 33 minutes in. We've only gotten into the mid-game at this point. ZYF has completed his MKB. This is despite the buyback around the Roche Pit. He still managed to cobble that together. CTY also getting close to his next big item, up to nearly 2K gold. And, well, you just look at the way these teams came into this tournament. With Ehome, a team that had to make it through the qualifier, they ultimately took down CDEC rather convincingly.
Their groups.
Oh, there's the jump. Gigantic leap forward. Looking for the solo pick on Zai mid lane. I don't think he gets this one, though. In fact, he's slept. He could be gripped here and turned against. He has the Aegis, though. Do you want to commit that much just on an Aegis? Secrets say no, we don't. But yeah, Blitz, you come back to the way these teams got here. And Ehome, it looked like they might even go into the lower bracket going into the last day, but they got the wins they needed. And here they are, coming back versus Secret on the main stage in Key Arena. Still an even game in terms of golden experience, but even, as you've been saying, feels good for Ehome.
Yeah, 2,500 is the mark that they're behind right now, but again, you want to be in this type of situation where the mech doesn't really add too much to Secret's lineup anymore, and the supports that they have are not nearly as effective as the ones that Ehome has.
And you can see the farm starting to kick in on these supports. You look at DDC, who's now, in terms of net worth, topping the support farm charge and starting to close in on Zai's offlane Spirit Breaker. He's got a Glimmer Cape, a Solar Crest. This Storm, this Gyrocopter are going to get so much harder to kill, and we saw last fight, as always, the power of a Winter Wyvern to just cold embrace a teammate in the fight. They couldn't scratch him.
But Arteezy, he's still got a monster amount of farm right now. We shouldn't discount that, even though he
Helm of the Dominator. This is going to be a 6-slot SF if this game goes on 10, 15 minutes.
Yeah, and once he has a Satanic, he's going to be incredibly hard to take down. He does deny that tier 2 tower at top, realizing it's incredibly low. Walks by, just gives it the one tap.
So if you're Secret right now, you look at the way the last fight went, like, what is the key to disrupting the Ehome team fight?
You have to charge on in, hit multiple targets, and not allow that Winter's Curse Phoenix Egg combo to go off. I talked about it early on. I said, it's not working right now, but eventually, if they hit that combination, it's going to be incredibly powerful against the BKBs of Secret, and you're seeing it time and time again. Their heroes are stacked up. S4 is wasting his BKB timer on it. So is Arteezy, and they have to spread a little bit better and not get hit by so many spells. Also, somebody has to keep track of CTY. It's not even about killing him in the beginning of the fight, but it's about being aware of where he is, who he's going for, and just keeping that... I don't know, it's really weird to say.
He's now got a Lincoln Sphere is the problem. Like, they can't charge him, at least not first. They can't reliably grip him. You talk about keeping him under control, but this storm is getting very difficult to even hit once. Oh, they're going to have to do their best here. They do have a BKB on Zai. Now he's going for the Courier Snipe, and CTY will claim it, taking away
That's a full AC.
Oh, goodness. S4 actually, I believe, still has buyback even through that.
That could have been a huge game changer, though, because Ehome, their only real physical damage dealers are that Storm and that Gyrocopter, and that would have really limited the damage that CTY could do, but being able to go for it, and CTY knows that Arteezy's there. I think he knows he's alone, too.
Uh-oh.
Arteezy's in pretty deep right now. Illusion's going to scout him on the way out. Do they want to jump for this? Hell yes, CTY says. I would love to make this leap, but he's really committing. Running low on mana. Doesn't have detection right now. He balls in yet again. They get the track on Zai, and Ehome just hunt after Secret. They do manage to pull Arteezy back, and they're going to follow this one up. In comes the track. Out goes the homie missile, and Secret get forced all the way back towards the well. Arteezy should be able to make it out here, but he's going to have to hoof it. Just the posture, the sheer posture from Secret, so defensive right now.
Yeah, that was a Storm that ran in with most of his mana and doesn't even care. They're just playing with reckless abandon. They realize the type of position they're in. They want to continue to push their advantage and just not let Secret get back into this game. And Secret... the Glimmer Cape on him is still really clutch to be able to save him. The gem is only on the Winter Wyvern, so he has to be really careful about how he casts it. But if they can blow up the Winter Wyvern before he gets his Winter's Curse off, which is what they were doing in the earlier fights, then I still see a really good chance for them in these fights, but that Winter's Curse is so brutal to them.
It's almost level 3 as well. He's getting so much experience on the Wyvern now. About to hit level 16, and he gets a blink. So now he can be even more mobile in the fights, and not a hero you normally are going to even be able to find for a charge, let alone be able to prioritize it. And well, Secret. It was something that was discussed by the analysts quite a bit in the early stages of the draft. Was normally they prioritize not only AoE for wave clear, but also just a little more team fight. And they have quite a bit of team fight from Arteezy, but as far as lockdown and control, it's just got to be crisp execution from them.
I mean, that's what you sacrifice in the lineup. When they decided to go for that five-man style where they were going to shut out CTY early, it worked incredibly well just because they knew that Ehome couldn't approach them. But as the fights went later and later, once CTY picks up his Bloodstone, you get your level 6 on both of your supports, it becomes incredibly hard for them to take that fight. And I just want to give a shout out to ROTK, that egg in that jungle where he was just pushing it to the absolute limit. We thought he was going to be unable to get off that egg, but it was just such a game changer. And now you're consistently seeing him get it off. You were talking about how he couldn't in the beginning of the game. Now it's just...
oh, and he just goes in deep. CTY punishing Puppy, gets slept up. Will it dodge the damage? No. Loses the gem. Curl. No, they haven't grabbed it yet. He's going to go for it.
He's going to get for a second one.
CTY with double gems. Literally balling out of control in this game. Styling on Secret. And that is big. The map control advantage that Secret have been just scrapping for all game. It's going to be removed with this pickup.
I'm impressed. I mean, he's just been a monster on this map ever since he's got his item set. The fact that he was able to dive in with two heroes backing up that Dazzle, they weren't interested in fighting either. They were just trying to get their Dazzle out of there. That's how they realized.
They even want the TP scroll. That's a bold mission for the courier. I mean, it looks like he didn't quite get vision on it. They're going to send it back in the end.
And Ehome.
I haven't seen Secret get out of the map in a while. They've been kind of cobbled into their own base here.
Oh, this is
again! Lanham striking deep, and this one also with a huge payload, 2,400 gold on that courier. That Secret just can't catch a break. Well, they're looking for more kills. CTY again with the leap, and because he's got the Leaking Sphere, they can't even focus him now. Will the Soul Burn hit him? They get him with the Shuriken, and now looking for Zai as well. They're swinging in from the south with RTK. There's not a whole lot of stuns left. They're going to nether strike them on the way out. Zai is, get me out of here, and they will dodge the cooldown. Finally, CTY runs out of mana, and the chase halts, but the damage is done. And you see the way the game has turned, what it's become. It's become Secret, unable to deal with a rampaging CTY, jumping them from halfway across the map, usually solo, with no fear, and the supports just, they can't be on their own.
Yeah,
they can't even be next to their teammates half the time.
The problem is if you decide to split up in front of the map, yes, you're farming a lot faster, but it's liable to just, CTY flies in halfway across the map. Yeah, I've seen that story before, but if you decide to group up, then he'll just split push, take your jungle, and then you can't gank him. That's what Lanham was for. He was just the guy who took the brunt of the gank, but he doesn't really care because it's a level 9.
Now, look at this. Are you serious, CTY? Again, he leaps onto Zai and he commits once more with an Aegis. He'll commit a Winter's Curse just to secure this kill. The grave comes out from B, but Zai doesn't even try to TP. Looks for the charge out. Can he make it? A blink, a leap. You can't run from heaven. All the lightning gods on display here. CTY doing his best Zeus impression. We'll get the kill.
It's so hard to stop him now with 15 Bloodstone charges. It's like 50 mana a second almost. Once he picks up, I think he should go for a Hex next, or even something like the Shiva's Guard. I would really like the Shiva's. There's not a whole lot of attack speed items on the side of Secret. yeah, I guess you have a Butterfly and an AC, but it would help a lot just for the rest of his team. And the AoE effect of the slow as you jump in is so strong in combination with the Storm roll, but in secret, look at their positioning. They have to five-man together at all times.
You very rarely see this from secret, even if they're losing the game. It's just the nature of the Storm in this game. They don't have much lockdown for him, and well, it certainly doesn't help that one of their heroes are dead, but now it's going to be DDC's turn to look for a bit of DE warding. CTY leaves him hanging. Should be able to get that gem vision. DDC's getting a little irritated here. Come on, buddy. Let's clean up this ward. We'll do so. Just missing the regen rune that it's on top, but doesn't have the bottle any longer.
CTY, he's just going to look to jump one of these supports in the back. He doesn't really care. He just wants to make the fight 4v5 as fast as possible.
And it just makes it so easy for RTK. He can just sit back and wait for a good time. He doesn't have to force it anymore.
CTY does that job for him now.
The Lincoln's pick feels like it's been a really nice item this game. And it's not often you see a lineup that literally is nothing except single target lockdown, but this is it. As the graph just plummets against Secret. We're now looking at almost a 20,000 gold sway over the past 10-15 minutes. The jump in on RTZ to start off. They have a Winter's Curse waiting for the opportunity, but DDC patiently holds it, realizing that wouldn't have been a multiple hero curse. They can do this again soon. Ball Lightning always at the ready. The Vortex coined out in 5, and no real danger so far. The Weave thrown out just to try and deter Eom a little bit at least. But the tracks keep on piling in. Three heroes now track. Want to get the first. Like, good luck stepping the next through.
There you go. The though for a Secret is that Eholm have a pretty terrible pushing lineup.
Four step in. They're going to start the fight that way. Lanham looking for the plays to begin it, but it's S4, and he's a little tanky. RTK says, let's go, let's go. Zai is going to be the first man. At the same moment, CTY jumps Kerr on the backside. He looks to blow up the Bane off the bat, but the bat from RTZ keeps him alive. RTK wins kept alive as well. These defensive support plays making the difference. And now, the egg! The egg! Full duration. Can they kill it off in time? They do barely. Just barely. RTZ will pop like a pinata. He's down for 90. He's a buyback. Again, the sleeps and the saves from DDC making the difference. And they're diving forward. CTY, life number two. It's a five-man wipe. Eholm. It's been a miraculous comeback for them. Very well played. And they're not done just yet. They track S4. RTZ and S4 fighting against the world. But any moment now, they could get jumped in. And the Eholm chants erupt. We might be in Key Arena. You wouldn't know it from how hyped this crowd is. S4, the next man jump. It's CTY again and again. He might even go for more here. Objectives. Objectives is the call. Take the Rex first. Celebrate the kills later. And that was, well, a 10,000 gold sway. And it might just be the game here. Secret, three down for 20. And Eholm aren't afraid at all. Continuing to muscle in, press up on the Rex, threatening to go in on Arteezy at any moment. He's being forced back just by some Vyburn harass while they take down two lanes of Rex. Secret in great danger of dropping the first game here on the main stage against a team that came in as an underdog for most.
I mean, we've been talking about CTY this entire game, but YJ has kind of quietly snuck in with a fully six-slotted gyrocopter at the same time.
It's just not as flashy of a hero.
Yeah,
but
you don't really notice it, but at the same time,
it's a lot of damage.
It's a lose-lose situation for Secret because they're worrying so much on the Storm Spirit, but meanwhile, at the same time, the gyrocopter is at the top of the net worth chart. It's not really close.
It feels like these fights are at the point now where even if one hero gets killed, like even if Secret manages to slam the egg, it doesn't matter because then they're not killing the Storm, then they're not killing the Gyro, and then they still lose the fight. And if they focus on the corpse, the egg goes off, they lose the fight that way. Oh,
those are the BM Dagons.
Oh, the BM Dagons coming out now.
That's level 4 too.
I consider in the way Lanham was haunted throughout this game.
Yeah, he's pretty pissed.
It's a pretty good Dagon 4. I mean, normally you'd say this is late, but Lanham will take it.
They can smell blood. I mean, if there's any signal that Eholm know they have this game wrapped up, it's the fact that he decides to go for the level 4 Dagon. Supremely confident right now.
Hey, BKBs are dropping low now in terms of duration.
Yeah, okay.
Dagon gets stronger late game.
You can buy a Hex.
They have an Orchid, okay, Blitz?
You can buy a Hex.
Touche.
All right, Secret, they're going to go for the GG.
This is the desperation
right
smoke. Do they get the initiation they're searching for? It could be a great winner's curse. DDC is going to hold it. They go into DYF as well, and they keep RTZ in position. The egg. The egg's there in the middle of everything, and nobody's focusing it. Floor's going to go down. Puppy on the run. It goes off. Kaboom! And Zai next. He's surrounded. There's the GG. But Secret will die before they can get out of this.
this game. Another five-man wipe and a devastating takedown for Ehome here to get things kicked off on our second match of the day.
And what game it was. That Storm Spirit, that's what I'm talking about. The Storm plus Bounty Hunter combo, you really can't underestimate that in secret. I mean, they just kind of look stunned right now.